In Chief Architect, you can import a variety of 3D symbols from third-party sources to use in your model. If we go up to File, Import, Import 3D Symbol, you can see all the different file extensions that Chief Architect can import. I'm going to go ahead and select this option, and then select a 3D object from my computer in the form of an SKP file, and go ahead and open it up. And on the Import 3D Symbol specification, you can see the files that you've selected for import and choose a category for the symbol. Choosing the correct category for symbols is important because symbols can interact with the other tools and features in the software. For example, if I was importing a cabinet door or a drawer, they could interact with the cabinet features in the software. Because this fixture that we're importing is just a sink, I'm going to go ahead and leave it as a fixture and interior. And then next, you can specify to add the symbol directly to your user library. And you can also show advanced options for modifying the symbol. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And next, you'll notice that I have a texture file name conflict message. I'm getting this message because the material textures on this symbol are already present in my textures folder. I could rename the imported texture materials, but I'm going to opt to use the existing texture instead of the imported texture. I'm also going to select to do this for all remaining texture conflicts in this import, and click OK. Next, you can see an outline of this symbol, and when I click with my mouse, I can place this symbol. Now that we have our symbol imported, it looks very odd. The materials don't look very good, and it's standing up on its edge. So let's open the symbol and adjust some of these settings. If I select the symbol, down in the bottom left-hand toolbar, you'll have an option to open the object. If I select this, I can modify the size, layer, materials, label, components, and object information about this fixture, just like any other fixture. But what we want to do is adjust the symbol so that it sits flat and so that it automatically inserts into cabinet countertops. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel out of this. And then down in the bottom toolbar, you'll have this option for open symbol. And at the top of this dialog box, we can specify whether we want to give this symbol a new name or include the size in our floor plan view. You can adjust the 3D geometry source, but in most cases, you'll just want to leave this how it is. Next, you can adjust the origin offset, and we'll come back to this more in a little bit. Let's go ahead and show the origin of this object. And next, look at the rotation of this object. We know that this sink is standing up on its edge, and so we need to rotate it so that it's sitting flat. I'm going to go ahead and rotate it 90 degrees in the z-axis and then 90 degrees in the y-axis. And there we have that sink sitting flat. Down below, you can see the number of surface faces on this symbol. This is a very important number because symbols with a high number of faces will slow down Chief's performance. This symbol has a low surface count, but some symbols may have a very high surface count and you need to be aware of it. Under the 2D block panel, you can adjust how the sink will look in our floor plan view. Let's go ahead and generate a new block. And then down below, you can also specify the fill, the color of the fill, and whether you want it to be transparent. Under the options panel is where you can integrate some of Chief's smart features into the symbol. Under special placement, you can specify how this symbol should interact with other objects in the program, and because this is a sink, we're going to specify inserts into countertop. Next, you can specify how this object should be treated in relation to your schedules, other requirements for this object, and the type of object that this is. We're going to go and specify that this is a kitchen sink. Under the materials panel, you can change the materials of the symbol. And then under the sizing panel, we can adjust some advanced sizing properties of the symbol, and we'll come back to this more in a little bit in another example. We're going to go ahead and click OK. And now we have that sink sitting flat. Let's go ahead and adjust the material on the sink to match the stainless steel material of the dishwasher and the oven. So I'm going to go and use my material eyedropper, select the stainless steel material, and then just apply it to the sink. Now that I have this symbol adjusted, I'm going to add it to my user library by pressing spacebar, selecting the symbol, and then adding it to my user library. Next, I want to go ahead and insert this sink into our cabinet. So I'm going to make sure I have the sink selected, and then just come into our plan and click on the cabinet that I would like to insert it into. And you'll notice that the sink is not inserting into the countertop correctly, and that it's actually floating on top of it, and we have a hole cut underneath it. The reason that this is happening is because the sink's origin is set to be at 0 inches, meaning that we're going to cut a hole in the countertop, but the sink will go 0 inches into the countertop. So, because this is a top mount sink, let's take a cross-section view and measure the distance from the underside of the top mount to the top of the countertop. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to our floor plan view, and we can just delete this extra sink that we no longer need. Go up to our camera tools, and I'm going to select the back clipped cross section, and you can also press Shift F12 on your keyboard, and then just click and drag a back clipped cross section through this cabinet and sink. And then zooming in close, I need to measure the distance from the top of our countertop to the underside of the top mount. And this might be easiest to do in a CAD detail so that we can select our CAD lines, adjust it out, and then measure the distance between the two points. So to convert this to just CAD lines, I'm going to go up to CAD, CAD detail from view. And now our view has just been converted to individual CAD lines. I'm going to zoom in close to the desired line and then just drag it out, zoom out a little bit, and then go up to our dimensioning tools. And I'm going to use the point-to-point dimension tool and select the line that we want to measure from and then measure to where the top of the countertop is. Press spacebar, and now I need to select this dimension number and get the exact value of it, and then I'm going to set our origin offset to be a negative value so that the sink sits inside the countertop and the cabinet. So I'm going to select this line. And you'll notice there that I've actually selected the dimension extension, and you can see that in the bottom left-hand corner. But pressing Tab on my keyboard, I can cycle to the next available object, which you can see in the bottom left-hand corner is the CAD line. And with that selected, I can select our dimension. And I'm going to press Control-C on my keyboard to capture that measurement. And then I'm going to go back to our camera view. And then in our user library, I'm going to right-click on the sink, select Open Symbol, go to our origin offset, and specify the Z value to be negative and then about 6 inches, and I'm just pressing Control V there to paste that value in. And if we turn on our origin offset in our 3D preview, you can now see how it's sitting below the origin starting point. So let's go ahead and press OK. And then let's go ahead and delete the symbol from the cabinet. And I'm going to select it, and notice there that I have the base cabinet in the bottom left hand corner, but pressing Tab I can select that sink, delete it, come back into our user library, and then just replace the sink. And now we have that sink correctly in our plan. Let's go ahead and close our user library, close our elevation views and our CAD detail that we opened, and then next look at resizing objects using stretch planes. If we orbit in our 3D view slightly, you'll notice that we have a pendant light in our scene. This pendant light is closer to the ceiling than I would prefer, and it looks like we have enough room between the pendant light and the countertop to extend it downwards a little bit. If I select the pendant light, I get a temporary dimension showing its size and handles that I can use to resize the symbol. However, if I select the bottom handle and drag it down, we're going to be resizing the whole symbol, including the light source and the mount, when really all I want to do is just resize this rod. In Chief Architect, you can specify very specific points on a symbol that you would like objects to resize about through the use of stretch planes. So if I go ahead and open up this symbol, and then go down to sizing, here I can see the bounding box dimensions for resizing the symbol, and then stretch planes. I'm going to go ahead and specify that we want a stretch plane in our Z axis, and you can see that that currently has a height of 0 inches. We're going to change this to be a value of negative 10, so that when we resize our object, now we're only going to be resizing it about this point on the object. So I'm going to go ahead and press OK, and with our object selected, just extend it down to 36 inches. And there we've resized our object just about that one specific point on the rod. And then the last thing I would like to do is get some copies of this pendant over our other seating areas. So I'm going to select the pendant, and then I'm going to use our multiple copy tool, and then specify our multiple copy interval. I'm going to specify that we're going to evenly distribute objects when dragging, and I wanted to distribute two more objects. Select OK. Move my mouse over the move handle, and you'll notice how it changes there. And then select and drag these two copies out. And then release. And now we have three properly sized pendant lights over our seating area. And if this was a pendant light I knew I was going to be using regularly in my plans, I would select it and then add it to my user library.